most of the Singer Studio type knitting machines have you cast on a different way using this ravel cord. It's actually live stitches. I don't know if I'm partial to this one. I prefer to do it a little differently, but just to show it because somebody asked about it. So first of all, you're going to bring whatever needles out to B position. I sometimes bring them out to holding position. You take your yarn, thread it through the carriage, and you knit one row across. Now it tells you to take this yarn and tie it around the clamp here. I don't do that. I just take a clip because I don't think they used clips back in the heydays when this machine was made. Then next, you had gotten a little thing of ravel cord. Now I have my own that I do put on bobbins, and I have to make sure that when I put this on, and I'm going to put a clip on just to hold one end in place for now, but I go to the left of the last needle, I go around the left of the gate peg there, and then I, on the right side, I go to the right of the gate peg, and I make sure that the ravel cord is not in the hooks. Now I'm going to put my tension dial up a little bit, just so I don't have really tiny stitches. And then you hold the ravel cord not too tight, but tight enough down below. Knit back. And the manual states to do 5 or 6 rows. So that's actually 2. And then it tells you to remove your ravel cord. And all you do is pull it sideways and it will come right off. And then it says to just continue knitting. Well, I would only use this for waist yarn. This machine doesn't want to do the weave and cast on for me like the newer studio machines can. I would just either start out with a closed cast on myself, but you just keep knitting. And sometimes, now that looped on me, it does, some of the other machines tell you to put the claw weights on the end, but you got to be careful, that first row is going to unravel. And the Singer type machines only need the 2 claw weights on. You really don't need a cast-on comb. Although I do have one made for a brother machine that I will use on this machine. I'll even use these on my bulky SK-155. It does work out a little bit better. And that's all there is to this cast on. Now for me, what I would do is actually take the waist yarn out, of course cut it, and I would work up a roll of ravel cord. So I could just go ahead and put the ravel cord into the sinker plate and just hold it up above because it's in the bobbin. And because I was pulling at, it did pull that end stitches. Then I would take and push my needles. Well, I'm holding the fabric down here, and I'm pushing the needles out to holding position. Then I would take, and I don't have any other yarn here. say this is going to be my main yarn. This is where I would do my closed cast on. Whether it's an E-wrap, latch tool, this is really not the best color to use because the light blue is close to this. But the pink ravel cord will separate. So just like in other cast-ons. This will work if this is what you want to do. Maybe try it and see if you like it. And once you got the work casted on, then you could continue knitting. You may, if you didn't have your counter going, set it so it's going to trip. If you had it going, reset the counter to zeros, and then start your work. And that's all there is to this cast on. With the newer machines, this one here does not show how to do the weave and cast on. But where I've done it many times on my other Singer Studio machines, I did put my weaving brushes on, which is a bar with the two brushes. You may have yours right in the Singer plate itself. But what I do is I bring out all the needles. And again, this is going to be more for waist yarn, starting out with waist yarn. For a few rows, and then a row of ravel cord, and then push the needles all the way forward, and do a push the material back against the bed, and then do a closed cast on. But for the weave and cast on, you thread the yarn through the carriage. You, like I said, you meant bring all every other needle out back to B. You lay the yarn over these needles here, and then you knit across. Oh, you also want to have the side levers forward for some reason. And there. So as I look at this, this looks really nice. And most of the Singer machines tell you to, as soon as you get probably about 5 or 6 rows, I don't have enough on yet, that you could hang your claw weight. But as you see, I'm not even using a weight. Although I do have a really tight stitch for this. I may have enough there now that I could hang the claw weight on. And with those tight stitches in the beginning, I forgot to look at my tension dial before I started. It's a little hard to get these on, but just wiggle them on. Now, I did notice that the end needle did not knit properly because I did not have the weights on. So now, I should be good to go. Yes, the end needles are knitting now. And if I want to start with the carriage on the right, as most patterns will tell you, you go ahead and cut your yarn. Do your row of waist yarn. Well, I want to have a clip on this. And then a clip on the ravel cord. I find it easier with the ravel cord between the waist yarn and the main yarn to separate it. But you don't necessarily need that. You could cut that last bit. Now here, I would go ahead and bring my needles out to holding position, pushing the work behind the open latches. Take my main yarn and start doing an E-wrap or a latch tool cast on. Now for those of you that do not like using the waist yarn and ravel cord, you just go ahead and start out with your E-wrap or your latch tool cast on, whichever one you want. There's also the double E-wrap and the figure eight E-wrap. The double E-wrap, you're actually knitting the first row with that, and that does make a nice stretchy cast on if you need that for whatever you're making. I have used that one in the past, but not too often. You normally see me with just E-wrap and so let me just push those needles back. Now I still have my weaving brushes on, my side levers forward. for those of you that have the newer machines, my bulky has the weaving brushes right on there. I just flip them down. Although sometimes I find those brushes will catch the yarn and either put them behind the gate peg or even not knit it properly. But if you have good brushes on, you shouldn't have any problem with starting out like that. Again, you may want to put your claw weight on the ends. It would be nice because sometimes these end stitches do not knit properly unless the weight's on there. Other times I have no problem, and actually for this machine and the manual, it doesn't even say to put them on after you cast it on. But the 155, the 860, the 360 I had, I think that was it for the Singer machines. The 840, the 580 I had for a while there, they all stated that. So the newer machines do tell you a little differently, but with this machine, I probably don't even need to put the weights on unless I notice those end stitches are not knitting.